Have you ever created the perfect spreadsheet? You worked out all the formulas and functions. You spent a lot of time on it. Then the next time you open it, you realize someone wiped out everything, your formulas, your formatting. Unintentionally, of course. It was probably someone who didn't really understand Excel. Do you want to make sure that all your hard work is not destroyed? I'm going to show you how to protect your sheet.
Here's a spreadsheet that's been designed to track contractor time. So it's the contractor timesheet. It's not too complicated, but there are some formulas in here that you would not want to be destroyed. So if we take a close look at it, I have the date in here, but right next to it is a formula. So all the user has to do is put in one date, and it will automatically plug in the following dates. And then there's some functions to add up the total number of hours worked, and then a total time. There's also a formula here that will automatically plug in the dates of the week here. And then this date for the signature is also a formula. So again, it's not a complicated spreadsheet, but there are quite a bit of formulas in here. So what I want to do is I want to lock down all of the cells that I do not want the user to mess with. I'm going to do this in three easy steps. Now, the first thing that I want to do is unlock the cells. So by default, all cells are already locked. If I come up here to Format, notice that the lock cell, you can see that it is gray around the icon because lock cell is turned on. I'm going to select all, my entire spreadsheet, Format, click on lock cell. Now that unlocks all of the cells. Now what I'm going to do is go back and lock every cell that I do not want the user to screw up. And I may need to use my control key on my keyboard. So I'm going to select this range here and this entire range, this cell and this cell. In this range right here, I'm going to come up to Format, lock cell. Now we're not done until we actually protect the sheet. So again, I'm going to go up to Format, protect sheet. And you can put a password in here to protect the sheet if you want to. In my experience, I have found that if someone is not familiar with Excel, they're not even going to know how to go here to unlock it in the first place. You want to protect the worksheet and the contents of locked cells. Everything here with a check mark next to it, you will allow users of this worksheet to do whatever you have checked. So if you want them to be able to format cells, put a check mark there. I like to deselect that, and I'll keep a check mark next to select unlock cells because that's where I want them to type into. If I want them to be able to do anything, then again, I'm going to put a check mark next to it. So now I'm going to click on OK, and if I click in any of these cells that I did not lock down, the user can type into it. But when I try to click within a cell that I have locked, the user cannot click in that cell. Notice I can't do any formatting. My ribbon is grayed out. So I've completely locked this down. Something that I do in the cells that I want the user to type into, I may highlight yellow. Then the user knows exactly where they could type. For example, let me go ahead and unlock. If I want them to be able to type here, and all of this, then I could lock down everything. And now the end user knows anything that's in yellow, they can type into. Or you might want to do just the opposite. Maybe you want to highlight yellow, the cells that are locked. That just gives a visual indication of what is allowed or not allowed. Okay, that was a very simple and quick way to lock your cells and protect that worksheet. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.